Hi, I'm Isaac, and welcome to Wanderers 2040.
Ooh, ongo na nongu,
nongu masu, nongu
masu
kani usangan reva
nasara,
meu sereta kaya wa na yada itio,
ongo na nongu,
nongu.
So I am joined here by a few of the Fijian Silktails and Fijian's pure athletes. Now, Wes, firstly, what was it like playing first grade footy?
Yeah, it was a dream come true for myself. It was an aspiration as a kid to play at that level, and then to finally do it for as long as I did, you know, was a massive blessing and something that I'm really proud of to this day.
Now, what inspired you to become the Fijian Silktails coach?
I just always wanted to, after I retired, after being in the game for so long, I wanted to give back. So I took a year out of the game to sort of figure out what that was, and then I found it in coaching. So I did my sort of like apprenticeship, as you say, with the Newcastle Knights, with SG Ball for 3 seasons. And then I got this opportunity to coach the boys back in Fiji. So it wasn't a hard decision to take that once that came up.
When you went back home to Fiji after being in Australia for many years after playing, did you see the Fijian Silktails or just the boys trying to play some footy, or just being back at Fiji, being bored, and you're like, you know what, I've got an idea, how about I try create a squad and maybe they can go further and play some good footy?
Yeah, so from Petro's vision all those years ago, that's how the Silktails began, and it was my job was sort of just to go back and just to pick, you know, what I thought was the best 28 boys to represent the club this season, and yeah, here we are now, and we're 10 rounds in.
Now, last year was a hard year for you guys, especially the Silktails and many other teams that were participating in the Ron Massey Cup. COVID hit. How did the boys feel when the news was struck that they weren't able to play?
Yeah, it was tough to swallow, but you know, COVID like really hit the world pretty hard. We had our first game against Windsor and had a good win, and we were preparing really well to go into the second round. When we got the news that the season would have been suspended, was going to be suspended. So from there we just had to do what everyone else did and every other workplace, and we had to send our players home. And then we just sort of just kept training from their home and that until it all cleared, and then we started the season again halfway through the season, in which I just played in the local domestic comp in Fiji.
Now, what's the character like around the boys? Like, say for example, a few tries are put on and they haven't scored. Are the boys heads down, or is it up when they score?
Yeah, I think like any other sporting team, you know, they try and react to it positively. They're all professional in the way they play the game, and we've got leaders within the team that when things aren't going our way, that they know just to get back on track.
Now, who's your captain for the Silktails?
Our captain's Penny. Yeah, he's not here today. Yeah.
Now, is there a main club that most of the boys are trying to get, like you could say, a scholarship or something with?
Yeah, so we're aligned with the Sydney Roosters. We're with them for the next 2 years. So if boys are playing well enough at this level, they can definitely get a step up in playing, if they're young enough, playing SG Ball, under 21s, or even New South Wales Cup, but ultimately NRL if it all works out.
So Inoke, what's it like playing in the Ron Massey Cup?
For me it's really exciting, and it's a dream come true too, you know, to represent Fiji in some sort of way. But I'm really grateful, and it's a really good experience for me, just 2 levels down from NRL. It's really good.
Now, a couple of years ago you were taken away from your family, and it's a long time being away from family. What was that like?
It's really hard, because I was here when my second baby was born. It's not new for me, because when my first baby was born, I was not with my first child. I was in New Zealand, and I know my wife is doing well, and it's really hard, but we can manage. It's all about communication and trusting each other, and I know my wife is doing really well.
Well, that's really glad to hear that you have a baby, and good luck for the rest of the way. What's life like being as a professional rugby league player in Australia?
Yeah, for me it's really new, because in Fiji it's you know, it's really hard. But over here I'm adapting to this kind of you know, background of NRL, and you know, it's really good to expose yourself in this kind of environment, especially here in Australia, because it's the national sport, and yeah, I'm really grateful that I'm here, and it's really different from Fiji, because we are adapting to this kind of material of rugby league in Australia. Yeah.
It's like an animal coming from a place to another, so it's like a polar bear in Antarctica now to a different place, just like that. So welcome, Molokai. What's it like playing for the Silk Tails in the Ron Massey Cup?
Well, it's a privilege for most of us boys going through stuff in Fiji at the moment, and being chosen out of thousands of boys, being one of the 28 boys being selected to play in the Ron Massey Cup, it's an honor. And it's been years trying to don't represent the national team in rugby league, and it's an honor to be in the Ron Massey Cup competition.
Now, I know you've been away from your family over in Fiji for a long time now. How does that for you?
Well, we've been in touch with family members back home with video calls every day, and it's kind of hard missing our family back home. Some of us young fathers, some of us just got married, and getting away from family members, it's really, really difficult. Luckily, because of the phone, we have messenger and all those communication stuff that we are able to connect with them daily.
Now, has COVID affected Fiji much?
Yeah, lately we've been experiencing few dropbacks back home. There's been a lot of cases coming in, and the country has gone to lockdown for a few days back, and schools have closed down, jobs have been lost, and especially the tourism industry, especially some government workers, they've been sent home because of COVID. And we are here representing the whole of Fiji in Australia.
Now, what's it like being a professional rugby league player over here in Australia?
Well, it's new to most of us. We just played in the local competitions back in Fiji. Most of us are farmers, policemen, army officers, some are students, some they got just stay home and look after their family. So being a professional athlete at the moment, it's totally new. We've got to experience a new environment, a new training facility, how we train every day, all those new experiences that have really topped us up.
Yeah, Australia, and particularly New South Wales, is very blessed to have you guys come over all the way from Fiji to represent Fiji and in the Ron Massey Cup, and we'll call you guys family now that you're over here, and we just want to wish Fiji all the best, and hopefully everything comes up instead of the down.
Meu ser retacaiawa.